Chandriya Vritaya
Tata Chandriya Vidyaya
Tata Chandriya Vritaya
Tata Chandriya Vidyaya
Jiva Shrestha Thi Ativanam
Jiva Shrestha Thi Ativanam
Tata prana brita shube,
tata prana brita shube,
tata sachita pravarat, pravaras,
tata sachita pravaras,
tata chandriya vritaya,
tata chandriya vritaya.
Jiva
Shrestha Jivanam
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata
Satchita Prabharas
Tata Chandriya
Tata Chandriya Vritaya
Jiva Shrestha Thiya Jivanam
Jiva Shrestha Thiya Vyanam
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata
Sachita Pravaras Tata Chandriya Vritaya Jiva Shrestha Hi Ajivanam
Jiva Shrestha Hi Ajivanam
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata Sa Chitta Prabharas
Tata Sa Chitta Prabharas
Tatas Chandriya Vritaya
Tatas Chandriya Vritaya
Jiva Shrestha Hi Ajvanam
Jiva Shrestha Hi Ajvanam
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata
Sachitra Prabharas
Tata
Chandriya Vritaya
Jiva Shrestha Hi Ajivanam
Jiva Shrestha Hi Ajivanam
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata Chitta Prabharas
Tata Sachitra Prabharas
Tata Chandriya Vritaya
Tata Chandriya Vritaya
Jiva Shrestha Hi Ajivanam
Jiva Shrestha Hi Ajivanam
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata Prana Vrita Shubhe
Tata Sachitta Pravaras
Tata Sachitta Pravaras
Tata Chandriya Vritaya
Tata Chandriya Vritaya
Okay. Jiva.
Jiva.
Living entities.
Living entities.
Shrestha.
Shrestha.
Better.
Better.
He.
He.
Indeed.
Indeed.
Ajivanam.
Ajivanam.
Than inanimate objects.
Than inanimate objects.
Tata.
Tata.
Than them.
Than them.
Pranabhrita.
Pranabhrita.
Entities with life symptoms.
Entity with life symptoms.
Shubhe.
Shubhe.
O blessed mother.
O blessed mother.
Tata.
Tata.
Than them.
Than them.
Sachita.
Sachita.
Entities with developed consciousness.
Entity with developed consciousness.
Prava. Pravara.
Pravara.
Better.
Better.
Tata.
Tata.
Than them.
Than them.
Cha.
Cha.
And. Indriya Vritaya.
Indriya Vritaya.
Those with sense perception.
Those with sense perception.
Translation. Living entities are superior to inanimate objects. O Blessed Mother, and among them, living entities who display life symptoms are better. Animals with developed consciousness are better than them, and still better are those who have developed sense perception. Purport by Srila Prabhupada.
Yeah.
Oh wait, you can repeat the translation. Living entities are superior.
Living entities are superior
to inanimate objects.
To inanimate objects.
O Blessed Mother.
O Blessed Mother.
And among them, living entities, who display life symptoms, are better. Animals with developed consciousness, are better than them. And better still, are those, who have developed sense perception. Purport by Srila Prabhupada.
Yeah.
In the previous verse, it was explained that living entities should be honored by charitable gifts and friendly behavior. And in this verse, and in the following verses, the description of different grades of living entities is given, so that one can know when to behave friendly and when to give charity. For example, a tiger is a living entity, part and parcel of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And the Supreme Lord is living in the heart of the tiger as super soul. But does this mean that we have to treat the tiger in a friendly manner? Certainly not. We have to treat him differently, giving him charity in the form of prasad. The many saintly persons in the jungles do not treat the tigers in a friendly way, but they supply prasad, foodstuffs to them. The tigers come, take the food, and go away, just as a dog does. According to the Vedic system, a dog is not allowed to enter the house because of their uncleanliness. Cats and dogs are not allowed within the apartment of a gentleman, but are so trained that they stand outside. The compassionate householder will supply prasad to the dogs and cats, who eat outside and then go away. We must treat the lower living entities compassionately, but this does not mean that we have to treat them in the same way we treat human beings. The feeling of equality must be there, but the treatment should be discriminating. Just how discrimination should be maintained is given in the following six verses concerning the different grades of living conditions. The first division is made between dead, stone-like matter and the living organisms. A living organism is sometimes manifested even in stone. Experience shows that some hills and mountains grow. This is due to the presence of the soul within that stone. Above that, the next manifestation of the living condition is development of consciousness, and the next manifestation is the development of sense perception. In the Moksha Dharma section of the Mahabharata, it is stated that trees have developed sense perception. They can see and smell. We know by experience that trees can see. Sometimes, in the growth, a large tree changes its course of development to avoid some hindrances. This means that a tree can see, and according to Mahabharata, a tree can also smell. This indicates the development of sense perception. Om Magyana Timirandasya
Jnanam Jnana Salakaya Chakshurum Ritandena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha
Vanchakalpatarubhyaisha Kripa Sindhubhaye Vacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha
Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shiva Sadhi Gora Bhakta Vrinda
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare.
Lord Kapila is guiding his mother in the process of devotional service.
Om Kapila Dev Kamram Nenam Mandivati Neka Nikitam Sitsalam.
In the previous section of this chapter, we heard about how to relate to the deity. That we should see all living entities as parts and parcels of the Supreme Lord. That the deity expands in the form of the super soul. And Lord Kapila told his mother to give gifts for other living entities. And we should also have friendly relationships with all the different living entities. So now Lord Kapila is describing how we should keep relationships with these different living entities. Because there are 8,400,000 different species of life. So we have to be intelligent to understand how to deal with the different species. So Lord Kapila is describing the relative positions of the different species of life. We know the human form of life is the most important. Because in the human form of life, we can study the scriptures and we can engage in the different activities of devotional service. But we should not deny other living entities the opportunity to also get some purification.
Mm-hmm.
Just like animals like a tiger, they are also part and parcel of the Supreme Lord. The Lord is in their heart, it's the super soul. So that we should think also how to give them some benefit. Of course, we cannot simply go and offer obeisances
to them.
And we don't embrace that. But we can give them, we can arrange to leave prasadam. And the, we said before, Rasikananda, a great devotee, a disciple of Shamananda, he had disciples, he had some tigers who were devoted to him. One mad elephant also surrendered to him and became his disciple. So not only dogs can be engaged in Krishna consciousness. So Lord Kapila describes the different stages of consciousness. So on the bottom there's inanimate objects which have no consciousness. Just like, you know, this floor has no consciousness. Building has no consciousness. Right? It's inanimate. But higher than that are living entities, which are some living entities who display life symptoms. Just like tiny cells, little cells or germs, bacteria, you know, they have some kind of life, they show some symptoms of life. They can reproduce themselves. And so they are considered higher than the inanimate objects. And better than this, they say better than this is animals, because animal has some developed consciousness. Develop consciousness. Animals, they have their senses, they can see and hear, they can smell. Different animals. We know birds can see very far away. They can be flying in the sky, they will see some fish in the water. And we see something, how clever the animals can be when they want things. So in the purport, Prabhupada talks about trees. The trees also sometimes display developed consciousness. He said trees can see. Just like the tree grows in such a way, it doesn't grow into the building, it will grow to the sunlight. If we were to leave the tree and position it in such a way that it would grow into the building, the tree will change its direction. It will grow up towards the sun. And Prabhupada quotes Mahabharata. He said in Mahabharata it says the trees can also smell. So I don't quite know how they use the sense of smell. We know we get but certainly when you're among the trees, you can feel the energy. You can feel the special, the particular energy which comes from the tree. It's very different being among the trees and being in a city. So, trees are very important in nature, that they have a very important function on the planet. Sometimes when a whole forest will be cut down, then it completely changes the course, the weather, nature, you don't get rain. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it tells about the Prachetas. The Prachetas were brothers, and they all went to do, they were the sons of Prachini Barish, and they all went to do austerities together. And after they'd finished their austerities, when they came back, they saw all the forests had grown, the trees had grown very tall. Nobody had been cutting the trees. So the whole planet had become covered with trees. Prachetas were very angry. In their anger, they produced fire and burned on the trees. It said also in the Kali Yuga, trees are very small. In previous yugas, the trees, just like people, were much taller. Trees also were much, much taller. So trees also have consciousness. This is the fact that not only trees, all plants, all different kinds of life, they all have consciousness, and that consciousness comes from the soul. A devotee has to understand the presence of the soul in all these different living entities.
เราต้องเข้าใจว่าดวงวิญญาณอยู่ในทุกสิ่งมีชีวิต
I have to deal with them in the proper way.
แล้วก็สามารถจัดการในทางที่ดีได
้ respecting them as like brothers and sisters, different form, you know, they're also life.
เราควรที่จะให้ความเคารพแล้วก็เหมือนกับพี่น้องกับพวกเขา
And we have the same father. We're all children. We're all children of the Supreme Lord. Krishna is the Supreme Father.
Now, in Luke Hong, Ombavan, Krishna bin Ombavan.
So we have to take care of them. We have to also, we should not be cutting all the trees just to put up more and more houses.
เราควรที่จะเป็นเพื่อนกับเขาหรือว่าเป็นพี่น้องแต่ว่าเราไม่ควรที่จะไปฆ่าหรือว่าไปตัดต้นไม้แล้วก็สร้างบ้านอย่างเดียว
And if you take trees, some often they take trees and make paper, and then with the paper, then they print so many useless literature.
บางครั้งต้นไม้นั้นก็เอาไปทำเป็นกระดาษวาดเขียนหรือว่าวาดอะไรวาดเขียนก็เอาไปทำแบบไร้สาระไม่มีประโยชน์
So we can take some. We're allowed to take what we need, but we should not take more. Just like we need some wood to build houses for our shelter, then it's allowed. But if we take more than what we need, then this is a sin.
ถ้าเราต้องการมากขึ้นแล้วก็นั่นคือบาป
Ishopanishad said, Ishavashyam idam sarvam yat kincha jagat yam jagat tena chaktena unchitaha magrida kashasvitanam Everything animate and inanimateThat is within the universe is controlled and owned by Krishna.
ทุกสิ่งมีชีวิตหรือว่าทุกอย่าง
มีชีวิต
หรือว่าไม่มีชีวิตก็ควบคุมโดย Krishna, Mother Krishna.
We should accept what is necessary for ourselves.
เราควรได้รับสิ่งที่จำเป็นกับเรา
But don't take more because it's not ours.
เราไม่ควรจะเอามากไปนั่นไม่ใช่ของเรา
And so Lord Kapila is instructing his mother and all of us in the importance of how to deal with other living entities.
องค์กบิลาได้บอกได้ตรัสกับแม่เทวทีว่าวิธีในการจัดการหรือว่าจัดการในการสิ่งมีชีวิตอื่น
They're not there just, they're not provided just simply for our sense gratification. They say, sometimes a Christian will quote the Bible. In the Bible it said, God gave man dominion over the animal.
ในมีคนเขียนในไบเบิลว่ามนุษย์สามารถควบคุมสัตว์ได
้ And so they think oh we have so it's okay we can kill
แล้วก็มันก็แปลว่าเราสามารถฆ่าเขาได
้ And we can eat them with our bellies and flesh
เราสามารถเขาได้เราสามารถกินเลือดเขาได้
So we are in a higher position. We should protect them. We should give them shelter. We should not just simply take advantage of and think they're just there for our sense gratification. Just like the vegetables.We take the vegetables and when we offer them to Krishna, then the soul is benefited and they will get a higher a human form of life. We collect the fruits and flowers and offer them to Krishna. The trees are benefited. But if we simply cut them, then this is violence. This is unnecessary violence. So Lord Kapila is teaching us how to have proper vision to other forms of life. And we should think how to give them Krishna consciousness. Okay, any questions, comments?
Like Mayapur, I listen some story. Yami Bhattarabhu say when in the night some dog is coming, when all is closed, the dog sun is coming, and take reverence to Prabhupada.
Take what?
Reverence to Prabhupada and the Murti Prabhupada.
No.
Reverence to Prabhupada and see Prabhupada quick go outside. And he giving class and say some devotees initiated for Prabhupada, the disciple of Prabhupada, because he is a spiritual master, please no beating or no say nothing to the dog because there's a devotee. Sometimes in protection in my approach. He is like he needs some prasad for the devotee. So this dog. No old dog, some dog.
ที่มายาปูมีมาเขากินประสาทมาหลอกก็ถวายเพราะว่าตอนนี้จะมาหลอกก็จะนิวัสปูบอกว่ามีบางมาจะมันสำคัญมันลูกศิษย์ของพระอุปัฏฐ์ชัดหน้าชัดก่อนจะมีใช่ไหมแต่ว่าชัดนี้จะเป็นมาแล้วให้ช่วยดูแลด้วย
Jananda Maharaj wrote a book about animals in Krishna consciousness.
Really? Yeah. Making new? I never.
No, some years ago.
Oh.
Yeah. You know, describe different animals who were showing Krishna consciousness. He said there was one cow. Used to come and sit in the class every time. Come and sit with all the devotees in class. And there was a chicken who was coming every morning in Kuala Lumpur to the temple and coming every morning for the Bhagavatam Club for the morning program.
He had one dog also here. He used to come inside. And he stayed till there, look around, stay, and then go away. He was doing like that for every day for some time. And then he stopped. I don't know, maybe died. Or...
Some monk. Buddhist monk, maybe.
To the story, right? Jada Bharata.
To deer.
Yes. He's telling the story about the Jada Bharata also there, right? He became a deer in the next life.
Yeah.
All yogis. Okay, Hare Krishna, Srimad Bhagavatam.